So, some of the 2015 turning points for me were I was going out of character for the Obama administration and standing up for what he was doing, the Iran deal where he unfroze some of Iran's nuclear assets, and of course, all the evangelical Christians that I knew, the Zionists, got a little tight. But one of the few things that Trump did I didn't like when he was on his bully back in 2015 or 2016 was that he disagreed with the decision Obama made in the Iran deal and said that he would have done things antinomically, completely different. And this was one of the few things, the only thing actually that Obama ever did in his 8-year administration that we like that pushed back the Benjamin Netanyahu style. I know I botched that last name. I think I've said this before, but his style of Zionism. See, even boomer Jews that I sometimes have on my friends list will say that making an enemy of Iran is nonsensical and more a style of him as the prime minister. Of course, they'll say that the real enemy is, of course, Russia, and ultimately, the Zionists will make the final boss for the United States, Russia itself. And they'll frame it in a way that makes Iran look more like a doflamingo and Russia a kite. For those people who are wondering, but the big point being, even they're not in line with making enemies of Iran. A lot of them are, but not all of them. And I've said before that I was jacking Donald Trump in 2015, 2016, even knowing this about him, but just the thought that he would go back on the only accomplishment Obama did that's positive. Like, people who like Obama already make a talking point that Trump's goal is to take away all his accomplishments, but what type of accomplishments are there? Both of them are ultimately a continuation of Reaganite economics and really the political environment as it existed since Bill Clinton. And that's ultimately an assessment that a friend of mine said, who also happens to be Iranian, that Donald Trump is essentially a 90s-style Republican, or 90s-style Democrat. At this point, the difference is negligible. So, all of that is setting to here, especially some of Iran's shit getting wrecked in Syria right now and the inevitable conflicts that I was already tight enough a few weeks ago with all the Syria bullshit, but definitely last year too, but this exacerbates that. And ultimately, he's going to say something that even my own subscriber base like, and they'll say to stop blackmailing, but to me, there is something that is hopeful and idealistic of taking the time to reject this man, having pride in yourself, and not standing up for someone who completely shits on you and all of your beliefs. Just because you're being knee-jerked by a couple of shitty Huffington Post articles and clueless Antifa members and normie leftists who think that Kekistanis are alt-righters. You guys aren't that. You're better than that. And I expect y'all to eventually realize that. This has been your boy, Miss 107.